So let's take a look at how to solve a story problem. Incidentally, a story problem is really just a synonym for word problem. A lot of books use word problems, some use story problems, the same thing. The key to solving a story problem is to figure out what equation you're supposed to be using. See, it's probably the equation you've been taught in the chapter of the book that you're working in right now, or the section of that chapter. So you can page back and check it out. That's usually a good hint. But once you know the equation, you want to get the info from the question, plug it into the equation, and then solve for what you don't know. That's the way to do it. That's just sort of this fail-safe way. It's a really great way. A lot of times when people learn that, they go from being pretty intimidated by these to finding that they're not so bad. So let's try. Zach walked 8 miles in 2 hours. How fast was he walking? So this is a classic distance equals rate times time question. Distance equals rate times time. And you can tell because what we've got here is a distance, a time, and a speed, a rate. Rate means speed. So let's plug in. So step one is identify the formula. Step two, plug in what we know. So let's see. You walked 8 miles. We know distance. In 2 hours, we know time. We don't know rate. So plug in what you know. Copy the variable, the letter for what you don't know. Step three, solve for what you don't know. And that's usually going to be the thing they wanted. So we want to solve for R. So to get R alone, to isolate R, we're going to divide by 2. 2 over 2 cancels. That's why we did it. R alone equals 8 over 2. 8 over 2 is 4. So his speed was 4. For what? 4 miles per hour. So in this question, Zach walked 8 miles in 2 hours. How fast was he going? He was going 4 miles per hour.